Let's find some treasure.
An ocean, a cave, a dream that no one could save.
We have about 5 miles to go until we reach today's fossil hunting location, but spots like these are why I absolutely love fossil hunting in Florida. Now, if you're ever fossil hunting in Florida and you see something like that, you are definitely going to give that as wide a berth as possible. Joe and I call areas like that sketchwack ponds, and they normally house gators and snakes and other stuff you really want to avoid. So we're gonna hike further down these tracks and get off of them to hike to the river. It's taken all morning, but we are finally at the river. Now, there is only a small window when I can actually come out to this river to fossil hunt. It has to be during winter and right after a flood, but it can't be when the river reaches its lowest point. If the river does reach its lowest point, then this entire bend will be just completely covered with sand. Every single bend in the river will be sanded over. And if it's in summer, there's a few things that could go wrong. First, it's normally flooded the entire summer. Second, the gators in here will be nuts. And there's also an algae that grows on the bottom of the river. The river stays low for too long, and it's impossible to see anything or do any fossil hunting. So this is really the only time I can come out to fossil hunt this river. Ooh, that's tight. Let's go. So a word to the wise, if you ever plan on fossil hunting in Florida, the first thing you want to do is check every single bank before you dive. So the reason why you would do that if you're in Florida is to look for one thing, and that one thing is a gator slide. So if you notice over here, you got a nice muck cover. If there's a gator sliding into the water, you will see a sandy approach into it. So something has been chilling over here, but it's not a slide, so it's most likely just some river turtles. But if you see a slide before you get in that bend, don't do it. Do not do it, it's not worth it. We do run into gators, you can't avoid it, but if you can and you know a gator's been chilling out here, don't get in the river. Let's find some treasure. So I only just started hunting this bend, and I had to crawl out to show you guys something really cool. So littered among those pieces of turtle shell was this piece to a giant beaver canine. This thing, if whole, would have reached from the tip of my finger to the base of my hand and would have belonged to a beaver the size of a bear. It's really amazing find, and crazy to think that during the Pleistocene, that beaver was swimming around and hanging out right here. Now that's got me pretty excited to see what might be in the rest of this bend. That's really cool. That's either an opossum or raccoon jaw, and it's got two teeth right there, and it is very well mineralized. So this bend's been pretty good so far, lots of bone. Let's see what we can't find.
So I just grabbed what I thought was a pebble, and it is definitely 100% not a pebble. It's a canine to a predator. So I'll go back underwater and grab this, and it is, oh, the bend we were in with the giant beaver is right behind us, and that is crazy. Wow, 100%, that is wicked. Ah, look at this thing. Look at that thing. Ooh, let's go get the nice camera.
This is why you pick up everything when you go fossil hunting. So what I thought was just a black piece of phosphate turned out to be a well-fossilized canine to a black bear. So this is the upper canine, and it could be lower.
Finds like this are extremely rare. I was much more likely to find either a mammoth or a mastodon tooth in this bin.
But the day is still young and I have plenty more to explore, so I'm gonna get back in the water and keep finding these fossils.
Big old gator tooth.
All right, I've finished hunting the first bend for today, and it's really incredible the biodiversity of extinct Ice Age animals that ended up getting trapped here.
In order, after the black bear canine, we first have a giant armadillo scoot compared to the modern one we found earlier,
a giant beaver molar,
a giant tortoise leg spur, a weird predator bone, we think, we haven't found one like this before, a horse tooth, that's an unerupted horse tooth, and then a gator tooth. So really diverse little spot.
But there's more cool animals to find out here.
Ooh. Nice tiger sharks. It was hard to tell underwater, but that might be a rare species of armadillo.
I'll have to identify that when I get home, but that could be a unique fossil.
That's a nice one. Extinct taper tooth. So many cool things in here. It's crazy. Love all the extinct animals that used to be in Florida.
This second bend ended up being very interesting. We got on a lens of gravel loaded with fossil tiger shark teeth, as well as some fossil gator teeth, but we did manage to find three really unique fossils over here.
So first, top right, we have this extinct taper tooth. From how wide it is, I can tell it's from the maxilla or the upper jaw, and it just got erupted because it doesn't have that much wear. We've also got something really cool that you don't find much of. That is a large snake vertebrae. Snake vertebrae are really, really iconic. So if you find one and you've seen one before, they're easy to identify. But that's a pretty cool snake vertebrae. And then this might be, I'm not sure, and if it is, it's my first one. But there's a rare species of armadillo that's a little bit bigger than the modern armadillo that we used to have in Florida. And I think that's a scoot-to one, and it would be my very first one. So at the end of the day, we'll compare this to the giant armadillo scoot we found earlier, as well as the modern scoot we found hiking out here.
I've already hiked further and I've checked the bends surrounding us, and they all seem to be pretty sanded over. So our best bet is to pack up our gear. We're gonna hike further down the river until we find another deeper hole, and hopefully we'll be able to get lucky again there. It is amazing that I've never broken one of these cameras. By the way, guys, I'm 6'3", so any normal person would not be able to do this. But I can. Oop, that's a log in the shin. We found another deep bend, but hopefully it's not too deep. We need enough flow that the river still exposes the bone. But the only way to find out is to jump in and see what we got.
That's another canine. That is definitely another canine. It looks big too. A little bit damaged. I'm on my tippy toes. Give me 1 second, I'll go pick it up. Here we go. Cool, another canine. Two in one day, that's nuts.
And there are more predator remains right below me. I think it's a jaw, I haven't picked it up yet, but we'll grab it real quick and see what it belongs to.
Deep over here, but yes, that is predator, and those are two teeth, two intact teeth. Oh, where's the rest of this jaw?
I've got to keep looking. If there's more predator material in here, this is going to be a very, very good day. It's already a really good day. Look at that. Woo! Not a predator tooth, but I think I've got something that those predators were eating. There might be a camel tooth below us, and I think it looks pretty nice, so I'm going to pick it up.
Yep, that's a nice camel tooth.
So today kept on getting better. This is the second predatory fossil we found in that bin. I think it's direwolf, but it's hard to tell with just these two front premolars. 4 feet in front of it, though, we did also get this canine. And so what I'm hoping is that this canine goes to that jaw, which would be so incredible. You do not find predator fossils like this that often when fossil hunting in Florida, and I am really lucky to have found these sets of teeth. Now, right in front of the direwolf jaw, hopeful direwolf jaw, was this camel tooth, and then this would have been predator chow. It is really awesome to see these fossils assembled like that. We've gotten an incredible diversity of different animals today. The sun's starting to go down a little bit, but I think we have enough time to hike to one more spot, dive it, show you guys everything we found today, pack up, and head home. I've got my dive light, so if it's dark, I'll hike hours in the dark. I don't care. All right, time to go river monster one more time today.
When fossil hunting, you sometimes have to get creative. Right now, I'm pinched between two fallen logs, because it's about 8-9 feet deep below me, and it's an easy way to rest instead of climbing out onto the bank. But right now, it's bombs away. Cool. Ivory and a horse. No, that's the deer ankle bone.
Nothing but a few isolated fossils and pieces of ivory to end our final bend, but days like these remind me why I'm so lucky to be able to come to these rivers and these wild places in Florida and hunt for these ancient animals. I've got to hike back to our gear, but I'll pack up, we'll get home, and we'll do this another time. This is so beautiful. I love these places so much. All right, I've just finished setting up the fossils that we found today. And boy, do we have a lot to talk about. I know the year has just started, but these might seriously be my rarest discoveries of 2021. Predator material like this is incredibly rare. I know that this canine is a black bear canine. I've handled a few before in comparative collections, and it's pretty familiar to me. But I wasn't as sure about this canine, which is a little bit larger, as well as this section of jaw. My current thought is that it is a direwolf, which is very, very rare. And the reason why I think that is that these teeth up here are pretty worn down smooth. Direwolves were bone-crushing animals. They'd crush bone to get to the enamel. And you can see all three teeth, the tops are worn very smooth. So I think these were found about 4 feet apart, are from the same animal. And I really hope and believe
that that's direwolf.
We were also very lucky in the amount and diversity of extinct Ice Age animals that we recovered. So over here we've got three very differently shaped teeth. The first one is a large molar from an adult tapir that's barely been erupted and has a little bit of wear. Too bad that the root is missing, but that is a very nice large tooth from a North American species, probably a tapirus varroensis. And then we've got a camelid tooth. So it's hard to tell the difference between Florida's extinct camels and llamas, but we do know that this was a very old individual that almost wore through its entire enamel crown. And then we've got a giant beaver molar. These things are so weird, and they're very rare to find. And one of the things I'm hoping to find is a complete canine from one of these. We found a piece of one to start the day today, but no luck besides that. Over here we have a large snake vertebrae. It's hard to tell what species. It is really easy to tell it's snake. I think that's a few wild pigs over there. Back to the fossils. If they get too close, I'll let you guys know. But that's a snake vertebrae. They're pretty iconic. It's probably rattlesnake. But that is really cool. But what I'm interested in is what was right below it. So on the hike out here, we found this modern armadillo scute right here. And then in the first bend that we hunted, we found this extinct giant armadillo scute. And to me, it's really cool to be able to visualize the size difference between these two animals. Mind you, this is actually a tiny scute for this individual, and that's actually a large scute for a modern armadillo. In the middle, I'm hopeful, not 100% sure yet, but I think that is a rare species of mid-sized armadillo we used to have in Florida. I will definitely have to double check with that, but that is really cool to visualize that size difference. Crazy animal this was. Now, today's theme really seemed to harp on weapons. We found these bullets while diving the same hole that had the direwolf material. And if you want to talk about a crazy prehistoric weapon, those canines are. We found even older weapons over here with a really nice lens of high-grade tiger shark teeth. These aren't that common in this river, and it's really cool when you find really nice ones like this. We also got the weapon that I am most wary of when I go diving, some really nice fossilized gator teeth from the Ice Age. Now, you might think of the Ice Age as being a place that would not be hospitable to gators, but the Ice Age here wasn't terribly different than what you see, actually. It was more of a savanna. I do know that I find more mastodon material in this river, so it's probably actually pretty wooded like it is now, but it wouldn't have been this crazy thing that you see in National Geographic with ice sheets and mammoths that were hairy. Now, the mammoths here were like the Asian elephant, the African elephant, and they were hairless. So it was actually a fine environment still for gators. Speaking of giant elephants, we did find some ivory and chunks of mastodon enamel. There's a bunch mixed in here too with the random bone that we found, but unfortunately, these rivers, when they're high, they are not kind to fossil material.
All in all, this is one of the best hunts for me in recent memory, and I am very thankful that I can share this with you all and upload these videos to YouTube. If you did like it, it really helps if you would share it or subscribe to the channel. And if you do, I guarantee that we will spend more time in these crazy rivers finding these ancient animals to share with you. So as always, keep on digging science.
For this week's video, we are giving away one of our very own Digging Science fossil hunting kits. All you have to do to enter to win is go to the comment section below and mention your favorite moment from today's video. Each kit has a 36-page color guide, 3+ pounds of gravel, and a magnifying lens to help you find all of these cool fossils.